You know, now's a good time to say thank you to one and all, to everyone here that's participating, for everyone that came here to help us celebrate the 250th wedding anniversary of Betsy Ross to John Ross. So give yourselves a big round of applause. Your cooperation, your participation is very appreciated. My name is Tom Gorick. I'm your master of ceremony for today. I'm a former Camden County freeholder and a former Gloucester City councilman. Acknowledge Mayor Dale Bale of Gloucester City and City Council for their unwavering support. Also the Gloucester City Historical Society, the Gloucester City Celebrations Committee. The guy who really, really, really put it all together, a lot of us, we know him by the name as Herc, but he's retired Gloucester City Police Department Lieutenant Joe Hargensheimer. Thank you, Herky! Joe?
I want to thank everybody for coming, but this is a great occasion. Everybody's happy, but we also have a little sad news. One of our committee members was supposed to recite a poem here today, Mary Lou, and unfortunately, she passed away about a month ago, and she never got to recite this poem. So we're going to play the poem now by the only guy that could do it as well as she could.
I walked through a county courthouse square. On a park bench, an old man was sitting there. I said, "Your old courthouse is kind of run down." He said, "No, it'll do for our little town." I said, "Your old flagpole has leaned a little bit, and that's a ragged old flag you got hanging on it." He said, "Have a seat." And I said, "Al, is this the first time you've been to our little town?" I said, "I think it is." He said, "I don't like to brag, but we're kind of proud of that ragged old flag. You see, we got a little hole in that flag there when Washington took it across the Delaware. And it got powder burned the night that Francis Scott Key said, watching it right, and say, can you see? And it got a bad rip in New Orleans, Pakenham and Jackson tugging at its seams. And it almost fell at the Alamo beside the Texas flag, but she waved on though. She got cut with a sword at Chancellorsville, and she got cut again at Shiloh Hill. There was Robert E. Lee, Beauregard, and Bragg, and the south wind blew hard on that ragged old flag. On Flanders Field in World War I, she got a big hole from a Bertha gun. She turned blood red in World War II. She hung limp and low a time or two. She was in Korea, Vietnam. She went where she was sent by her Uncle Sam. She waved from our ships upon the briny foam, and now they've about quit waving back here at home. In her own good land here, she's been abused. She's been burned, dishonored, denied, refused. And the government for which she stands is scandalized throughout the land. And she's getting threadbare and she's wearing thin, but she's in good shape for the shape she's in. 'Cause she's been through the fire before, and I believe she can take a whole lot more. So we raise her up every morning, we take her down every night, We don't let her touch the ground, and we fold her upright. On second thought, I do like to brag, 'cause I'm mighty proud of that ragged old.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sure Mary Lou is looking down upon us right now. And simply by means of background, we are celebrating the 250th wedding anniversary today, November 4th, here at Historic Proprietors Park, when Betsy Ross Elizabeth Griscom, a good Jersey girl, who was born January 1st in 1752, and she moved to Philadelphia when she became an adult to train as a seamstress. And she came back here to Gloucester City. At the time though, we weren't quite a city, we were a town. So she came back to Gloucester Town on November 4th, 1773, to marry actually one of the signers of the Declaration of Independence, Mr. John Ross. So once again, thank you for participating, for being here, for being good Gloucesterites, for being good Jerseyites here as we reenact the 250th anniversary of the wedding of Elizabeth Griscom to John Ross. And today they will be married, husband and wife, as Mr. and Mrs. John Ross. Also want to say a big thank you to the participants from Gloucester City High School's ROTC and the Gloucester City Marching Band. And this is such an appropriate venue as we look around at Philadelphia and the historic Delaware River. We're so rich in history here in Gloucester City, we couldn't be any prouder. And we oftentimes mention Hugs Tavern and all the activities that took place at Hugs Tavern. Let's give all these wonderful volunteers a big round of applause. They look wonderful. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to turn the microphone over to Gloucester City's Mayor, Honorable Dale Bale, who's also the Justice of the Peace, James Bowman. Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. I, James Bowman, Esquire, one of His Majesty's Justice of the Peace for the County of Gloucester in the province of New Jersey, I do hereby certify that on this day, John Ross of the City of Philadelphia and Elizabeth Grisham of the same place, spinster, appeared before me, and by virtue of a license from His Excellency William Franklin, Esquire, Captain General and Commander-in-Chief of the province, were joined together in the holy bands of matrimony and are pronounced man and wife under my hand seal on this day, 4th of November, 1773.
And now for the procession of the wedding party, we would like to introduce Sam Long, who is portraying William Hug Jr. He is escorting Kate McElry, who is portraying Sarah Harrison Hug. Next in line in the wedding procession will be Landon Johnston, portraying Sheriff Ellis, and Brianna Weimer portraying Abigail Ellis. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Jacob Spotts portraying John Ross and the flower girl, Ileana Simons. Betsy Ross
Griscom.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure and an honor to turn the microphone over to the Honorable Mayor Dale Bell, also known as the Justice of the Peace of Gloucester Town, John Bowman.
Gathered here today in the presence of this company to join this man and this woman in matrimony, which is honorable and is not by any to be entered into unadvisedly, lightly, but reverently, discreetly, and soberly into this civil estate, this man and this woman come now to be united. If anyone therefore can show just cause, while they may not be lawfully joined together, let him speak or forever hold his peace. I charge you both, as you stand in the presence of these witnesses, to remember that love and loyalty alone will avail the foundation of a happy home. And if the solemn vows which you are about to take be kept steadfastly, you will endeavor to your life will be full of joy, and a home you are establishing will abide in peace. John, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaken all others, keep only unto her, so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Elizabeth, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaken all others, keep only unto him, so long as you both shall live?
I will.
John, please repeat after me. I, John.
I, John.
Take you, Elizabeth.
Take you, Elizabeth.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better.
For better.
For worse.
For worse.
For richer.
For richer.
For poorer.
For poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
And thereto,
and thereto
I pledge to you my faith.
I pledge to you my faith.
Elizabeth, please repeat after me. I, Elizabeth.
I, Elizabeth.
Take you, John.
Take you, John.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better.
For better.
For worse.
For worse.
For richer.
For richer.
For poorer.
For poorer.
In sickness and in health.
And to love and to cherish.
And to love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death do us part.
And thereto.
And thereto.
I pledge to you my faith.
I pledge you my faith.
The wedding ring is an outward and visible sign of an inward bond which unites two loyal hearts in endless love. Please repeat after me.
In a token and pledge.
In a token and pledge.
Of the vow between us made.
Of the vow between us made.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And pledge to you.
And pledge to you.
My constant faith.
My constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
Now, the bride will go. In a token.
In a token.
And pledge.
And pledge.
Of the vow between us made.
Of the vow between us made.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And pledge to you.
And pledge to you.
My constant faith.
My constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
Whereas Elizabeth and John have consented to be joined together in holy matrimony, and have witnessed the same before Almighty God in this company, and have given and pledged their faith each to the other, and have signified the same by joining up their hands. Now therefore, by the authority vested in me as Justice of the Peace, Gloucester Town, County Seat of Gloucester County, Province of New Jersey, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
cross, ladies and gentlemen. Also, additional thank you to Jace Harker, the sixth great-grandson of Gloucester's own, Betsy Ross. Those of you who are lucky enough to have tickets for the reception, a full reception will be held at Elizabeth Ballroom in Highland Park section of Gloucester City, with fun and frivolity.
Jacob Spots and the bride, the beautiful Natalie Azari. Everybody to start putting up on their buildings and waving, so we have a plaque for them. Did you notice the bride today, the beautiful gown she had on? That was made by a very talented dressmaker, Miss Paige Mathis. Paige, could you come up here? Paige is a student at the University of Syracuse. There you go. Thank you, Paige. Here's a lady that I don't know how many messages I sent her in the last several years, but she was always ready to help me, and I just couldn't have done this without her. Miss, well, you know, I hate to say this, but I needed a lot of help doing this. I mean, this didn't happen overnight, and I needed a lot of help. So I had to contact the Betsy Ross House in Philadelphia. They gave me so much information and so much help. And by the way, the flag that the ROTC raised today used to fly over the Betsy Ross House in Philadelphia. Wow. It would be refolded, put in a plaque, and sent to the Gloucester City Historical Society. Miss Lisa Ackermolder of the Betsy Ross House. Thank you, Lisa.
Thank you.
Gloucester City High School. Can I have Rachel Marie up here to accept this for Gloucester High School? Thank you.
Thank you.
And we'd like to ask the real life descendants of Betsy Ross to come up here, the Harker family. And a big hand for the Harker family.
John Harper.
I think the whole thing was perfect. Oh, here we go. I don't know what to say. I'm speechless. I mean, this was a most beautiful, beautiful event. And Joe, you did a great job. You did a great job. We're very blessed to be part of that family and the descendants of Betsy, and we're very blessed to be here today. Thank you very much for having us.
And last, but certainly not least, our wedding party. These kids have been, they've been great. If this morning they were at the high school early practicing with Mayor Dale Bell, and they've just been great. First, I'd like to ask Landon Johnson. Thank you, Landon. Nicole. Thank you, Pete. And how sweet was that flower girl, huh? Was she just sugar and spice and everything nice? Eliana Simon. Sam Lowe. Thanks, Sam. You did a great job.
Sam.
Miss Brianna Wimmer. Jacob John Noah Spots. And our beautiful bride, Natalie Betsy Ross and Barry. She is the great granddaughter of Stu and Jean Weisgerber from town. And her great, great grandfather, Mr. Charles Weisgerber, actually lived in the Betsy Ross house, and her great-grandfather was born in the Betsy Ross house, and her great-great-grandfather, Charles Weisgerber, painted a beautiful portrait called Birth of Our Nation's Flag. That portrait was used to help raise money for the preservation of the Betsy Ross house. So who better to play Betsy Ross? And now we got it.